What is good, everyone? OJ over here from Player Essence, and welcome to another video. Today we've got some awesome information, so let's go ahead and get right into it. And we're starting off with Yo-Kai Watch 4. We have the first screenshot and the setting introduced as well. So this was big information, guys. This was big news. Everyone was linking and tagging me this, so thank you to all of you guys for that. But we do have some information that has been shared about the latest adventure in the Yo-Kai Watch franchise. So Level 5 has released the first screenshot and setting introduction for Yo-Kai Watch 4, its first Switch entry in the RPG series, due out in Japan this winter. So as you guys can see here, you're seeing this nice screenshot. And yeah, it looks like we were talking about before in terms of the original Yo-Kai Watch before it was put over on the Nintendo 3DS. It looks like that, but better. Obviously, this isn't necessarily a full, like, high-resolution screenshot, but it looks good enough just to give us an idea of the tone and the feel of Yo-Kai Watch 4 for the Nintendo Switch. And yes, it looks considerably better than a Yo-Kai Watch on the Nintendo 3DS, which is to be expected considering the leap in power that you see from the 3DS to the Nintendo Switch. Now, let's get into some more of the details of the game. So, characters from each world will appear. You have Keita, Natsumi, and Shin, the protagonists of the three worlds of Yo-Kai Watch. Jibanyan, Junior, Nekomata, and the Yo-Kai of each world will appear in the game. So you have Natsumi's world, and as you can see her right there. And then you have Keita's world, and then you can see that right there. And then you have Shin's world, and you see that right there. So all three of them are there, and as you can see, the designs of each of the Yo-Kai get slightly more demented or darker depending on the world, with Keita's being the balance, and I think with Natsumi's being a little bit more of the crazier demented, and then you have Shin's being more of the dark world. So Yo-Kai Watch 4, once again, is the first entry on the Nintendo Switch. If you're just looking to get into this franchise, it will be the first one. I know it says Yo-Kai Watch 4. There's been multiple other Yo-Kai Watch games that have been released in Japan and have been a bit late to come over to the West. So if you haven't heard about Yo-Kai Watch, or if you're just getting into it, Yo-Kai Watch 4, I think it will still be a place to where you can jump in, and I'm pretty sure Level 5, they're going to do something to where they make sure players are comfortable jumping into Yo-Kai Watch 4, just because there's going to be a lot of people that are interested in this game, a lot of people that pick up this game that probably didn't play Yo-Kai Watch 1 through 3 or missed some of them just based on slow localizations or just based on they didn't want to play it on their 3DS or for whatever reason. But Level 5 also says that you can enjoy a new Yo-Kai Watch world presentation with evolved graphics. And all of this information, of course, link in the description below. But I did want to talk about this just a little bit more, because Yo-Kai Watch 4, to me, is going to be one of those games that is going to help Nintendo in terms of the big push for the holiday season. People have been talking about that in terms of what Nintendo has. And Yo-Kai Watch 4, just because it's not American, just because it's Japanese and it's only confirmed for that, people aren't talking about that game enough. But that is going to be a huge system mover, in my opinion, or system helper, in order to get a lot of units out there in Japan. And I'm just wondering, I'm like, man, Nintendo, they really need to gear up for this holiday season, because this game is coming out winter, right? So winter could technically be next year as well, because I don't think they said winter 2018. They just said winter. But I'm thinking that it's going to be this December, because Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee is November, and then they hit them in December with Yo-Kai Watch 4. So we'll have to wait and see exactly when the game launches. I think they're just trying feverishly to get this game finished, and if it's finished in 2018, they'll release it, then it'll go to next year. That's why they say winter, you know, and they don't give an actual year, like winter 2018, they just say winter, so that could go into next year. But overall, I'm excited about this game. I think it looks really good, and hopefully we can get it here in the States in a timely fashion. So what do you guys think about the first screenshot for Yo-Kai Watch 4 in addition to the setting and introduction? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Alright, and moving into the next topic here, Super Smash Bros. Ultimate estimated to take up around 16 gigabytes of space, but this is not final, but I did want to get into this here. So Super Smash Bros. Ultimate has received an official listing on Nintendo's Japanese store recently. Now on this listing, we get a little bit of a rough idea in terms of how big the file size for the game will be. Nintendo does say you'll need at least 16 gigabytes of free space. So with several months away, this definitely could change, guys. This is not final in terms of it. They could get it underneath that 16 gigabyte threshold or that space. It could be more as well. We just don't know because they're still rounding out content. They're still probably polishing up things, adding features, doing what they need to do. So we'll just have to wait and see on that. The game is set for December 7th. 2018. So once the eShop listing actually goes up, then we'll definitely have more of an idea of what it will be. I'm guessing that they want to keep the game below the 16 gigabytes so they don't have to use the more expensive card. I don't think Nintendo wants to use a 32 gigabyte card, and I don't think Smash Brothers is going to take up that much space. So I do think that 16 gigabytes or under is probably likely for this style of game. This is a huge game, and it was funny because a lot of people were like, oh, what, 16 gigabytes? Like, that seems to be too much. Like, Nintendo, I thought they were going to do like 10 or 11 or something like that, because they're comparing it to like Legend of Zelda or comparing it to Super Mario Odyssey. But you can't compare those games, in my opinion, because Super Smash Bros. Ultimate has music, and music takes up a lot of space, and it has music from all these different franchises. It has stages, a crazy amount of stages. It's going to have a crazy amount of content. The game looks beautiful. There's a ton of stuff in there to do. So it's not always like comparing the exact same thing, you know? It's not always doing that, especially with the amount of music that's in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Has a nice graphics boost as well. So I would expect this game to take up around 16 gigabytes of space, but that's just my expectation. I don't know if that's going to be the 100% fact, but I would expect it to be, yeah, like a larger size game to where it would take up pretty much that full 16 gigabyte card, or pretty close to that, just because of what Smash Brothers is all about. Heck, Super Smash Brothers on the Wii U took up a lot of space as well. That was well over 10 gigabytes. So I do feel that with Smash Brothers and everything that they're adding in here, all the DLC from the previous game, in addition to pretty much all of the stages and then some, all of the new music from all the different franchises that have been represented in this one here, bringing back those stages and even more that we don't know about. Yeah, this is definitely going to be one of the larger games that Nintendo produces from a first party standpoint. So what do you guys think about Super Smash Bros. Ultimate when it comes to the estimated amount of size and also the release date as well? You guys excited for this one coming out this December? I think it's going to be a lot of fun playing through the game with you guys. A lot of cool stuff. I wonder what they're going to do with some of the other things. We've got some rumors that Smash Tour and also Smash Run will be making an appearance as well, but those are just rumors. We have to wait on those. I'm hoping for Subspace Emissary to come back, but actually make it good, unlike Subspace Emissary on the Nintendo Wii, which it was okay for what it was at the time, but I definitely don't think it was that great. But that's just my opinion on the matter. I know a lot of you guys do like it out there. So what do you guys think about all of this information and news here? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. All right, I'm moving into the final topic here. Octopath Traveler seems to be selling out in Japan, and Square Enix has actually had to issue an apology. So we don't exactly know what Octopath Traveler is doing at this point. We'll have a better idea once the Media Create sales charts hit next Wednesday. But for right now, it does seem like the RPG is off to a fast start in Japan. And this is according to Square Enix directly. So on the official Twitter account, an apology was posted for the game selling out, which is happening during a 3-day weekend in Japan. Square Enix recommends considering the digital version to fans who are looking for a copy of the game. And this is something that I kind of reported on a little bit beforehand, with one of the bigger retail stores in Japan, or retail chains in Japan, selling out of the pre-orders. Like, they were selling out of pre-orders, which isn't very common for a lot of games out there to sell out of pre-orders. And I don't think Square Enix and Nintendo shipped a ton of stock when it comes to Octopath Traveler. I think they shipped a good amount, but I don't think they shipped a ton, as if it was like a Final Fantasy game or like a Dragon Quest or something like that. But to see the game having some sellouts, that's definitely good, because then more orders are put in and that can get the flow rolling when it comes to it. On top of that, I think more and more people are going to be picking this game up. The 3-day weekend though, I think they probably should have anticipated that a little bit more, that people would be looking if they're interested in this game, which is a classic old school style of RPG reminiscent of Final Fantasy VI and Chrono Trigger and all those golden age RPGs. I think they should have anticipated just a little bit more that people are going to be interested in this one. But I just don't think pre-orders were maybe booming all throughout Japan. Now, in some places, yes, absolutely, it was doing really good. But I don't think pre-orders were, like, amazing in every single place. Although, we did see on Amazon Japan, number one on Amazon Japan, number one here in the States as well, number one in various different areas when it comes to it. So maybe they could have done a little bit better, maybe not, but either way, it's just good to see Octopath Traveler at least having this type of interest to where it would sell out or would even be considered as selling out, because this game, I've been playing it for around more than, if you consider everything when it comes to the first demo, the second demo, and now the main game, I've put like more than 12 hours into it. I think I put around 16 to 17 hours. I actually played more last night, so it could even be more. And it's fantastic. It is exactly what I wanted out of the Nintendo Switch. This is the perfect Nintendo Switch game when it comes to it, because it plays beautifully in handheld mode. It plays beautifully in docked mode. Frame rate is absolutely perfect, obviously. Art style is amazing. You can play with the Joy-Cons detached, and it's awesome to play like that. You can play with the Pro Controller just like it's a classic RPG. Every single feature that the Nintendo Switch has, which makes it appealing, is definitely built and fine-tuned for this game. The HD Rumble is amazing when you break opponents, especially using the Joy-Con split. The HD Rumble is absolutely phenomenal when you're buying and selling weapons, like the money feels like you're handing out coins when you're opening a door. It's just great. It's fantastic. And to me, like I said, it is the perfect Nintendo Switch game in terms of features that it uses. Portable play, docked play, everything is great in this game. It's phenomenal, and I'm absolutely loving it. So what do you guys think about Octopath Traveler selling out in Japan in addition to Super Smash Bros. Ultimate and the file size and the first screenshot of Yo-Kai Watch 4? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. All right, Ninja, that wraps it up for this video here. Go ahead and check out the links in the description below. We got Facebook and Twitter. Go ahead and give us a like and a follow on our social media. Really helps us spread the content of Polaris across the internet in addition to YouTube. Also, make sure you check out our Patreon, Twitch, and YouTube Live gaming pages and consider supporting Player Essence. When you do so, it gets you access to all sorts of cool benefits, perks, rewards, and emotes via YouTube sponsorship. So check out the link in the description below and consider supporting Player Essence right here on YouTube. Hit that like button if you did like this video. Let me know you guys want more content like this going forward in the future. And subscribe to Player Essence for its RPG, Japanese, and Nintendo gaming news. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll catch you in the next video. Peace!